In 1939, with war quickly approaching, the Royal Navy realized it needed some higher-end convoy escorts for higher threat areas. Something more durable than the Flowers, but not as good as the fleet destroyers. Something that could handle air and sub-attack, but didn't need to face surface battles. Oh, and building them fast would be good. 1939 and all. The result was the Hunt class. The first batch came out too top-heavy, so they had to lose one of the planned mounts and carry permanent ballast. I'm getting Hatsuharu flashbacks. The second group was wider, so in my opinion was just right, as it allowed them to regain the lost mount. Then they messed it up, and on the batch 3s, swapped a gun mount for torpedoes. I don't understand. Yes, I know this was so they could fight surface battles in the Mediterranean, that makes no sense. They're convoy escorts. These were good ships for their size and role. They especially made a name for themselves in the Mediterranean and English Channel. Some would say their 4-inch main armament was too light, but you have to remember their main role was anti-aircraft and ASW convoy escort, not surface action. They also carried a good number of depth charges. With the benefit of hindsight, in my opinion, the Royal Navy probably should have canceled all of its destroyers after the JK class, including the Ns, and just pumped these things out. Like the contemporary LM and N classes, they mostly entered service from late 1940 through late 1942. Many were loaned or outright sold either during the war or after to friendly countries, so expect to see this class again as I cover other free navies. While under construction, three of the 1,050-ton Batch 2s were loaned to the Polish Navy. Kujawiak, originally Oakley, was started November 22, 1939 and completed June 17, 1941. Krakowiak, originally Silverton, was started December 5, 1939 and completed May 28, 1941. Slazak, originally Bedale, was started May 25, 1940 and completed April 17, 1942. Main armament was three twin 4-inch 45 caliber dual-purpose open-backed mounts, one at the bow and two super-firing aft. Two depth charge throwers and three depth charge racks were fitted for 110 depth charges. Propulsion was provided by two boilers venting to one funnel that provided steam to two turbines for 19,000 horsepower. Each turbine ran a propeller for a top speed of 27 knots. Radar started out as the types 285 and 286 with type 128 sonar. While undergoing refit in late 1942 through early 1943, Krakowiak and Slazak traded their types 286 radar for type 291. Krakowiak entered service in late May 1941 and joined by Kujawiak the next month. They began training. In late July, they began escorting convoys around home waters until December when they took part in Operation Anklet, the raid on the Lofoten Islands meant to capture an Enigma machine. With that successfully completed, in January 1942, they returned to escorting convoys in home waters. At the start of June 1942, Kujawiak transferred to the Med and joined the escort of the large Malta-bound Harpoon convoy. While entering the Grand Harbor on June 16th, Kujawiak hit a mine and sunk. Krakowiak, meanwhile, remained in home waters, joined by the new Slazak in June. While Krakowiak escorted convoys until mid-1943, Slazak took part in the failed August 1942 Dieppe raid and then returned to home water convoy escort. In January 1943, Slazak was damaged in a storm and spent the rest of 1943's first quarter undergoing repairs. In June 1943, they transferred to the Med and escorted the invasion of first Sicily, then Italy. In October, Krakowiak moved to Alexandria and supported operations in the Aegean for the rest of the year and the first quarter of 1944, while Slazak stayed in the Central Med, operating out of Malta. April saw them return to England, where they prepared for and took part in supporting the D-Day landing. With the battles moving inland in August, they moved to the North Sea and spent the rest of the war escorting convoys around the North Sea and English Channel. Post-war, they were returned to the Royal Navy.